الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، I speak with you. Unfortunately, I'm in the hospital since last week, but I insist to speak with you even if I'm in the hospital, inshallah, because we don't want to lose this opportunity to meet with you, inshallah, رب العالمين. Life is very short and we must do something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. Last week, we spoke about some ayat from Surah Al-Hashr and the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hashr. And as I mentioned before, and I like to repeat myself, we're not speaking about tafsir. We're not speaking about tafsir of Surah Al-Hashr or any ayah, most of the ayat that Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen reported in his book. We're not speaking about tafsir. We're speaking about the aqeedah on the ayat. The aqeedah, the tawheed on the ayat. That's why in the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sifa, that the attribute, the description, we adopt some of the description and some description we cannot adopt. Some of the description we cannot adopt. And also last week I said we will speak about what is subhanallah? What is subhanallah? Because as it's still in Surah Al-Hashr, subhanallah amma yushrikun. Subhanallah amma yushrikun. I'm not making also translation, but explanation. Now la ayna in the salah, we say subhanallah, 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 subhanallah 33 times. Why we say subhanallah? What is the meaning of subhanallah? That means تنزه الله سبحانه وتعالى من كل نقص أو عيب. Said Allah سبحانه وتعالى, say He is pure, complete, perfect from any deficit, any deficit, or any defection. We can have a deficit, like for example, I'm in a hospital now, there is deficit, defection. I might die, I might live. So that is, I am not a complete, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one created me, and the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدٌ Subhanallah, أي البعد, the word subhana, subhana البعد, معناها the distance. Subhana, that is the distance. Subhana من كذا, the one من كذا, subhana from so and so, that means that so and so is far or distance. So some people will do something bad to you, you say subhanallah ya akhi. This is something you are wondering, you say, subhanallah, that means you don't want that, that means the bu'd, that means the distance with the subhana. فتسبيح الله سبحانه وتعالى أي إبعاد القلوب والأفكار على أن تظن أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هناك نقص. That's mean all the thinking and the hearts. We have to believe there is no deficit in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No deficit, and any evil is not related to Allah. Please give me attention to this. Any evil is not related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الله سبحانه وتعالى يعلم في ظاهر الغيب أننا سنفعل كذا وكذا شر. Allah knows in the past when He created the soul that we will do so and so. We will do so and so as an evil والعياذ بالله. Allah سبحانه وتعالى told us, this is my way and you follow my way. فلا يضل من اتبع هدايا. Allah عز وجل سورة الطه. ومن اتبع هدايا فلا يضل ولا يشقى ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى. Say whoever follow my way, my guidance, my هدى, فإما يأتينكم مني هدى فمن اتبع هدايا. Whoever follow my هدى, my guidance, the guidance is Allah سبحانه وتعالى, that is the عقيدة, that is the عقيدة. من اتبع فلا يضل ولا يشقى. There is not going to be a stray or misleading the road. ومن أعرض عن ذكري. Whoever rejected the ذكر of Allah, the عقيدة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, ده توحيده في الله سبحانه وتعالى. فمن ظهر هذه فإن له معيشة ضنكا in this life have a miserable life. ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى in the resurrection will be blind. قال ربي لما حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا. قال ربي my lord why you raise me blind while I used to have sight, I used to see. قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا. I give you my آيات. I give you my guidance. فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى. You forgot the guidance and you will be forgotten today. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى protect us from that يا رب العالمين. So سبحان الله. When I say سبحان الله that means Allah سبحانه وتعالى the absolute with no deficit or defect or anything like this with the people in the people characters or characteristics. نعم إن شاء الله. So هو الله الله عز وجل هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. The end في سورة الحشر الله سبحانه وتعالى says هو الخالق هو الخالق الخالق بعد العدم. I mean there is nothing before but Allah. Nothing but Allah سبحانه وتعالى create everything from single things. Like look at this. He used a tree from what? The tree. From a seed. Who created that seed? الخالق الله سبحانه وتعالى. Me and you from a seed. From the father and the father. Who created that small tiny microscopic seed is Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The sun, the moon, the earth, all this from one single cell. Who created that cell is Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And subhanallah, everything is his indication of tawheed. By the way, brothers and sisters, please give attention to this. One of the miracles. Everything around us is from one single cell. One single cell Allah Azza wa Jal created. And from that cell, he made galaxies. From that cell, he created the sun. From that cell, he created the earth. From that cell, and create me, and create you, and create everything else. That is the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Miracle, my dear brothers and sisters. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, huwa al-khaliq. Al-khaliq. This means that when he have a complete his qudra, his ability, his power can create everything from nothing. And give me attention. Ala ghayri mithalin sabiq. There is no similarity before Allah created a human being. Different than create the animals. Gift different than creating the jinn. Different than creating the angels. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. We create the human being in the best picture. Look at the human being. The eyes, the nose, the mouth, the hands, everything, there is a reason. We're going to speak about this in more details. Look at this hand here. Look at how many fingers I have, 5 fingers. If there is no thumb, Ibham, if there is no thumb, it's not easy for me to catch things. So that thumb and that in this position, this thumb in this position, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-khaliq. There is a reason Allah created this thumb in this here, in this position. Not with the hand like this. No, here's to catch things, to hold this, to control things, to control things. See, my dear brothers and sisters, so that is al-Khaliq. This universe, look at the universe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the sun. And if from the sun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all those planets going around the sun from one single hydrogen atom. And look what happened. With billions of years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created a galaxy around the sun. And many, many suns here in the universe. Allah Azza wa Jal has created. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has created. All right. So that is Al-Khaliq, the creator. And only Allah. When I said أحسن الخالقين, as I explained this before to you, but let me just repeat what أحسن الخالقين, that means أحسن, the best of the creator. What does that mean? That means there is other creator than Allah. Other creator than Allah. The carpenter, I said, I mentioned to you, if you remember, carpenter created the door. But that door from where? From the tree. Of this is the iron from the earth, from the iron. But who create the iron? Who create the tree? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even this iron, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to the earth. Allah azza wa jalla send the iron to the earth. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدِ وَأَنزَلْنَا سُورَةَ الْحَدِيدِ وَأَنزَلْنَا we send the iron to the earth. So the iron came to the earth, not without, from within the earth. And the scientists, they discovered, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than 1400 years ago about this miracle. That who did that? Al-Khaliq. Al-Khaliq. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هو الخالق البارئ. 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 The one, the maker. Evolver. But what is the difference between الخالق and البارئ here? الذي لا يقلد أحد. Allah is not imitating anybody else. Allah عز وجل not imitating anybody else. That means I am a unique creation. The animal, unique creation. The bird are unique creation. The fish as unique creations and so on. Everything's unique creation. So البارئ is the one he create things without imitating anybody else. That متميز, unique. No one, so a human being different than the animals. Man different than the woman. The woman different than the animals and so on. That is البارئ. Also, one of the meaning of البارئ, one of the meaning of البارئ, please give me attention to this. Man, الموجد والمبدع, the one he exists, making existence, the existence and making unique. Existence and unique. Okay? That البارئ. And then also another البارئ, making differentiation between one things and the other things. That means we are better than the animals. And the animals itself better than each other. Human being, Allah عز وجل فضلنا بعضكم على بعض. So human being, us, different than the others. We are different. Some rich, some poor. But what is the different, the true difference in people? What is the true difference? Give me the answer with that. What is the true difference among the people, brothers and sisters? What is the true, the really true difference among people? Anybody can give this answer. What is distinguished people of people? Yes, Yusuf. Taqwa, very good. Very good, taqwa. Yes, somebody is also taqwa. Yusuf said taqwa. Taqwa, that is the true. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the distinguished. And who can measure the taqwa? Who can measure the taqwa? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one he know what is in the heart. لا إله إلا الله. الحمد لله. Okay, البارئ again. البارئ, the one he create, not imitating anybody else, is unique creation. And we said there is a meaning for البارئ, the one he created from existence, the nothing, and he creates something new with that from it, no nothing, from no existence. And also البارئ, the one he distinguish between people and people, people and animals, the creation together, they distinguished. And البارئ, some ulama, and this is very nice also, that البارئ, the one he created Adam from sand. He created Adam from sand. Is that true? Yes. We have 21 elements here in my body, 21 elements. If you have a wet sand and analyze the sand microscopic, and you find the same elements exactly. the same elements exactly. That is al-Bari in summary. Bin al-Musawwir. La ilaha illallah. Al-Musawwir. Say al-Khaliq al-Bari al-Musawwir. What is that? Translation in English, very weak. Fashioner. Fashioner, what is fashioner? No, the one making everybody with a specific picture. Every creation with a specific picture, specific features, even us, different features. Look at this here. Look at this here. What is that? What is it in my hand? Huh? What is that, brothers, sisters? The thumb. See, the thumb. Is my thumb like yours, Haytham? Is my thumb? Of course not. So how many billions of people Allah Azza wa Jalla has created with this fashion, al-musawwir, with a different thumb? Different thumb. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. That is al-musawwir. Only Allah can do that. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can create and do that. Now they're making the UPS. This is the UPS, the slide, the number, and scan it. And still there is a certain number and they cannot do anymore because it'll be similar. It'll be similar. That's why they're making new UPS line, new every day. But for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't need that. كن فيكون, and that's it. That is المصور. المصور, الله عز وجل says in Surah Al Imran, هو الذي يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء. Allah عز وجل says, the one God who shapes you inside the womb of the mother the way He wants, He wills. Inside the womb of the mother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us different, even the twins. They identical, they look like each other. Maybe they look like each other, but impossible. Their character will be uniquely different. Their shape different. There will, some of them will be strong, some will be weak. There is some kind of differentiation even if they are identical. We say they are identical. We say they are identical. Please, no one should play with the al-Huda. Don't play with the picture, please. Yeah, don't play with it. Just leave it as it is. No, don't lie. Just don't worry because we're gonna lose everything. The ayah, I will mention the ayah, inshallah. Everybody have the book in there, inshallah. Because if we play with it, we're gonna lose the picture. We're gonna have a problem again. So open the book in your hand, inshallah. If you have the book, open the book about the last or the Quran, the last two ayat from the last ayah from Surah Al-Hashr. That easier, inshallah. Open that, if you have a Quran, the last ayah from Surah Al-Hashr, that's what we are talking about. In the book, there's no explanation in the book anyway. So open that, inshallah. Open that. All right. So again, al-Musawwir, Allah Azza wa Jalla also, he came, the word al-Musawwir, in this ayah, in Surah Al-Imran, yusawwirukum. Yusawwirukum is the same meaning. Al-Musawwir, الباري المصور in سورة الحشر يصوركم in سورة آل عمران آية نمبر 6 in سورة آل عمران آية نمبر 6 in سورة آل عمران. Alright. So and the meaning also there is another meaning for that المصور. There's some other meaning for المصور other than what I mentioned. That the one he is the one he create his creation with their shape according everybody he have a different hikmah. Allah Azza wa Jalla, for every person there is a hikmah in creation of every single person. There is a wisdom. Subhanallah, subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Every individual there is a hikmah. Impossible you'll find two couple think alike. Say in American slang, this is great mind. Huh? What a great mind? Great mind what? In American slang, example slang, they're saying. Think alike, very good. Great mind think alike. Think alike in some area, but impossible to be perfect. Impossible. Like my husband and wife. See, I want my wife to be just like my thinking. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Rum. Surah Al-Rum, ayah number 30. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Rum, ayah number 30, if I'm not mistaken. Allah azza wa jalla said, Fitratullah alladhi fatara an-nas 'alayha la tabdila li khalqillah dhalika ad-dinu qayyim. Fitra. Everybody, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create him or her from a certain fitra. Fitratullah alladhi fatara an-nas 'alayha la tabdila. There is no way to change the creations, the characters, the behavior of the people. See, I can train my son to be different character, but still everybody is have his own character, subhanAllah. Especially husband and wife, he want men, they said, always men, they said, I want my wife to think just like me. I want my wife to think just like me. Impossible. I want my husband to think just like me. Impossible. Husband and wife, they have to be different. But if when I like follow the stream and the wife, she want to just go with the stream, it's okay. Just let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Alhamdulillah. She's good. Or the opposite. To avoid some problem. No, alhamdulillah. But al-musawwir, the one I have a different shape. So one of the meaning of al-musawwir, he create us with a shape, a different shape, and different hikmah for each person. Different hikmah for each person. Okay, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when on musawwir, he makes the person tall, some people short, some people beautiful, some people not really beautiful, some people female, male, that on musawwir. See, musawwir, all this, not the only fashioner, no, al-musawwir, he is the one, he create nash'a, yansha'a al-khalq, the creation, tall, short, in between, black, white, blue, this, that, Chinese, Japanese, Arab, and so on, and so on. So everybody has his own character, his own shape, that is al-musawwir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-khaliqu, al-musawwir, what is in your book? له الأسماء يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض يسبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض تسبيح تسبيح of praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى by the way one of the شعبة of الإيمان Shu'ba or branch of belief. Tasbih, when the branches, when the branches of belief, it is what? At-tasbih, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, and of course, tasbih, the branches of the Iman 70 and some branches, and this is not our topic, but at-tasbih, one of the branches. What is the tasbih? Praising Allah, what does that mean? I'tiqad, that means believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no similarity and no similar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one acting like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one in power and authority like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means anything we can carry it, Allah khilaf dhalik, not like that, not like us. Say so whatever come to your mind about Allah, that means I can be like Allah, astaghfirullah al-azim, or somebody, that means again, the tasbih is to believe, tasbih, when say subhanallah, what does that mean? That means you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no similar, no imitation, no partner, no wife and husband, بالعياذ بالله. And any of the people have that weakness, weakness. What is this weakness? Or poverty or death is not related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I have to remove this from the character of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the tasbih. Tasbih that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala munazzah an dhalik, tanzih. Tanzih that means Allah azza wa jal, he never have this, what I just mentioned, all this to you. All right? So we have two types of tasbih. Two types of tasbih, bismillah. There is a tasbih بلسان الحال and tasbih بلسان المقال in Arabic. And we're going to explain it in English, inshallah. Explain it, not translated. Tasbih بلسان الحال, that means all my body, all my body making tasbih to Allah. All of my body, all of my body making tasbih, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And تسبيح المقال with the tongue. تسبيح المقال with the tongue. Alright. Let's understand what is that تسبيح. My body. تسبيح الحال. الحال that means the body. It's عام. It's general. What do you mean? That mean كافر. His body making تسبيح. Yes, of course. Yes. Of course, making tasbih. What that mean? That mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created my body and everybody's body is also. Allah created all the bodies, all human beings, all the creation. Do you believe in that? Do you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the creation? I believe in that. Everybody believe in that. Alhamdulillah. Even non-Muslims. Even non-Muslims. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them who created the heaven and the earth, they will say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لأن سألتهم من خلقكم? Who created you? They will say Allah created us. We believe in that. This means my body and his body and her body praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is called the hal. المقال only the believers. Why? The one he is not making associate with Allah. The one he is not making partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His tongue mentioning Allah azza wa jal. His tongue says subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. So we have two types of tasbih. Tasbih al-hal, that means all the creation making tasbih. Human being and animals and birds and insects and everything and the mountains. صلى الله عز وجل إن عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها. See, this is the mountains and the heaven and the earth. They praising Allah. They worshiping Allah. That is one. The second one, مقال, that means the speech. Who is that saying Subhanallah? Only the believers. May Allah make us among the believers, inshallah. May Allah make us among those, the believers, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Okay. Can we make al-hal wal-maqal, al-hal, the body and the speech? Yes, we can do it. Me and you, we can do it. Why? My body praising Allah and my tongue praising Allah. That means hal and maqal praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us among those people always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alright. So lisan al-hal, fa'amma lisan al-hal, again let's go to lisan al-hal, what is in the body. In the body, that is that this universe also, this universe, who created this universe? Who created the universe? Allah. Imagine this is the sun. My hand is the sun. And this is the earth. And this is the earth. What does the earth do with the sun? Go around the sun and around itself in the same time. around the sun taking what? How many months? Taking around the sun, how many months? How many months the earth going around the sun? Give me, show me, huh? 12, very good, 12. 12 months, the season, that's why we have winter, we have autumn, we have spring, 12. And around itself, how many times around itself? Huh? Show me numbers. Around itself, how many? Once, exactly, 24 hours. No, 365 a year, Haytham. But the whole year, 12 months. But around itself, 24 hours almost. 24 hours, that's why we have day and night. Day and night. And that is so accurate. So accurate in the way only لسان المقال, لسان الحال do that. لسان الحال, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one, he making this sun and this earth rotating, rotating. And this earth rotates very fast. That's why we have a core, that's why we are sitting here. If we have no gravity, what's going to happen if we have no gravity? If we have no gravity, what's going to happen to us? Hmm? Yeah, exactly, we're going to fly. If there is no, what caused the gravity? What caused the gravity? Huh? What caused the gravity? Our weight? No, not our weight. What caused the gravity? The air? No, not the air. Come on. Masses? No, not masses. Now, the core of the earth, the core is rotating very fast, and that making causing the gravity, is exactly, is it the core of the earth? Very good, Haji. If the core of the earth causes the gravity, that's where we are sitting. If the core stop, that's it, we are in trouble. We're gonna fly. It's not easy to go home. See, it's not easy to sit in this bed. Yeah, subhanAllah, that is lisan al-hal. Who do this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the earth in this kind of fashion. Fashion who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is lisan al-hal. That means this kind of accuracy, there is no weakness. There is no lousy. You know, some people, they're drawing a very, very beautiful drawing for a building. Very beautiful building, mashallah, gorgeous. And another engineer come and look, there is a mistake here. There is a mistake here. Impossible to be perfect the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the perfect one. And all what we see around us, this fashion, this universe, that we can lisan al-hal, that we be, Allah is al-musawwir, Allah is al-khaliq, Allah is al-bari'. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. That is the tasbih. This earth going around is tasbih. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Allah Azza wa Jal says, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. الَّذِي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Why? وهو العزيز الغفور. عزيز الغفور. We spoke about عزيز last time. الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا. ما ترى. Listen carefully. ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من ها من وات من تفاوت. Very good. ما ترى تفاوت. What is the distance between the earth and the moon and this planet and Mars and Mercury? There's a certain distance. If this distance become like not accurate for like a few centimeters, that's it. The whole universe, the whole galaxy will be gone. The whole galaxy is that يسبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. Be with me here. You with me. يسبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. With this kind of accuracy, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالكون شاهد على ربوبية الله. The whole universe is witness بلسان الحال. Brothers and sisters, the whole universe bear witness that Allah is a Rabb. And we explain what is Rabb, right? We explain what is Rabb. That means the one who خلق and take care of this accuracy. And he have the power and authority to control the universe, not only one galaxy, not only the earth or the sun or Mars or Mercury. No, the whole galaxy, Allah control it, and the other galaxy and the other galaxy and the stars and the planets and so on. And you name it, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, la ilaha illallah. And the great creation, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making tasbih to Allah. Who is the great creation making tasbih to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who are those the great creation, they always making tasbih to Allah azza wa jal? Who? Angels, very good, yes. Are the angels, because they see this accuracy, they see this power from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam, naam. التسبيح والحمد طرفان لشيء واحد. التسبيح and حمد. تسبيح is praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And الحمد is thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Two edge for what? For one thing. الحمد إثبات صفات الكمال. الحمد would say الحمد لله. الحمد you approve or confirm the accuracy of the description or attribute of Allah. Please give me your attention. It is really important. الحمد to confirm the perfection, the accuracy to of Allah subhanahu that the attribute of Allah. Perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tasbih, the opposite, it is nafi, sifat al-naqs. There is no deficit in the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you with me here? Again, let me repeat this again. Say, at-tasbih and al-hamd is two things. Two edge, for one thing. Alhamd, you prove, confirm the accuracy, the perfection of Allah. Prove, tasbih, you said there is no deficit in the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we have to believe in both. Alhamdulillah, subhanallah. الحمد لله سبحان الله. This is the way. تسبيح does mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no deficit. He is complete and perfect. But الحمد إثبات. That means confirm. All right, inshallah. Then الحكيم. The word of الحكيم is three letters. Supposed to be حكم or حكم. حا and كاف and ميم. حا كاف ميم. We're going to speak about الحكيم. طبعا the translation is the wise one. Okay. The translation of al-hakim, the word of the translation with the wise. But ya Allah, the word al-hakim, the original word for al-hakim, ha and kaf and mim, hakama or hukm. All right. So لها معنيان two meaning for الحكيم. حكم and إحكام. Give me your attention please. حكم and إحكام. حكم ruling. حكم ruling. إحكام perfection and إتقان. إحكام perfection. Perfection. And that you need for ruling and perfection, you need hikmah. You need wisdom. Please again. The root of hakim, ha, and kaf, and meem. Ha, kaf, and meem. That is the root. Two meaning for it. Hukm. That's the ruling, authority, and ihkam is perfection, itqan. And for both, you need what for that? Hikmah, wisdom, you need al-hakim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, all right. So, hukmullah, either kawniyan or shar'iyan. Is it kawniyan? What is that kawniyan we said in English? Is that word in English? Kawniyan. Or shar'iyyan, let's go as was kawni. Kawni when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kawni with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created the things and ordered, just like the rain, for example. The rain coming down, or the wind, or the winter. That is kawni. Kawni. That means ruling hukum by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kawni is hukum by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is kawni. And then, Shar'i, that is the ruling. What Allah order or prohibit, that call it Shar'i. Again, they have two for hukum, either the hukum or the ruling of Allah, either kawni or Shar'i. Kawni, that means ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is hukum kawni. Kawni, that means the rain will come down, ordered by Allah, the wind ordered by Allah, cold weather ordered by Allah, hot weather by Allah, and hurricane by Allah, waves by Allah. So all this by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is called kawni. Yeah? And then shar'i, legislations, creative will. Yeah, kawni is a creative will and legislative will. Of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means what is that shar'i? What Allah azza wa jal ordered or prohibit. Let's have understand in some ayat together, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Mumtahina, Dalikum hukmullah yahkumu baynakum. Please give me your attention to this. Dalikum hukmullah yahkumu baynakum. This is the command of Allah by which He judges you. ذَلِكُمْ حُكْمُ اللَّهِ. That this is the ruling or the command of Allah which He judges you. This is kawni or shar'i? Kawni or shar'i? Anybody can tell me. This is kawni or shar'i? Is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Anybody? Shar'i. Haytham, very good. That is shar'i. Shar'i, because Allah makes the ruling between the people. Allah makes the ruling, and we must follow those ruling by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair. Kawniya al-iradiya. Okay, all right. Creative will, the creative will. Now, read the other one. The other one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Yusuf. Yusuf alayhi salam, the brother of Yusuf. قال فلن أبرح الأرض حتى يأذن لي أبي أو يحكم الله لي. Please give me your attention. Say I'm not going. I shall never leave this land until my father give me a permission or God may decide for me. That كوني or شرعي, legislative will or creative will. Shar'i or kawni, this one. Again, let me read. فَلَنْ أَبْرَحَمْ not going to leave this land, the brother of Musa, of Yusuf, Yusuf alayhi salam. I'm not going to leave this land until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, until my father gave me permission, until my father gave me permission to leave the land or Allah make decision. That kawni or shari'i. We speak about al-hakim. Anybody. This is creative will or legislative will. Haytham. Shari'i? No, not shari'i, Haytham. It is shari'i. Because his father making the rule, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is making the rule. Making the rule. Okay, now let's, yes, he said both. Let's say the ayah في both. أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين؟ أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين؟ That is both, ياسر. That is both. Why? أليس that Allah سبحانه the best of the judge. That means there is a judge in dunya. We have judge here, and Allah is the best judge. The best judge. So there is a judge judgment in earth among you know they have a judge and the judge give you that and there is a judge Allah سبحانه the best of the judge. Allah Azza wa Jal is the best of the judge. Allah teaching the judge what to say. That is both. Yes, Jazakallah khair, inshallah. So that is a, all this we're speaking about the name of Allah, Al-Hakim, Al-Hakim. So, what about Salah? Is Salah Shari'i or Kawni Salah? Shari'i or Kawni Salah? Shari'i, very good. Shari'i, why Shari'i? Why Shari'i Jannah? Why Shari'i? Obligation because Allah is there. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order you. Fasting and all the fasting and hajj is Allah. This is Shari'i. Jazakumullah khair. Jazakumullah khair. All right. That is the Al-Hakim that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the last one. And he said, the author said, أن يقول المؤلف the author said ونؤمن بأن له ملك السماوات والأرض. He said and we believe that Allah سبحانه وتعالى the king the owner of the heaven and the earth. Allah is the owner for the heaven and the earth. Anybody else say something else other than that? The Jews believe in that? Allah on the heaven and the earth, the Jews believe in that. Anybody can tell me, is the Jew? What is that? This state of will does not have to take place. It may be taking place. It's, who is that? You didn't know? You did that? Okay. All right. Now Allah Subhanahu wa Taala on. The owner or the creator of the heaven and the earth. Allah is the creator for the heaven and the earth. Everybody believe in that or not? The answer is yes. The Jews believe in that. Christians believe in that. Muslims believe in that. Guess what? Buddhists believe in that. Hindus doesn't. Okay, but even the nature of a human being. We said even those people that doesn't believe that the communism, the communist, inside them, believe me, because I'm saying inside them because I know a lot of them, inside them there is a belief, this yes, there is something, they believe them. But especially Native Americans, what about Native Americans? Native American believe in God, believe me. Native American believe in God, in nature, that Allah behind the nature, that's the Native American. All right. Now, Allah subhanahu the author said, the يقول المؤلف ونؤمن بأن له ملك السماوات والأرض. And he brought two ayat from Surah Shura. Two ayat from Surah Shura. Let's go see what he's saying, why the author said about that. Allah Azza wa Jal said, له ملك السماوات والأرض يخلق ما يشاء. يهب لمن يشاء إناثا ويهب لمن يشاء الذكور. يخلق ما يشاء الله عز وجل. الله عز وجل فرس له ملك السماوات والأرض. الله he owned the heaven and the earth, the own the ever and the earth. And then look at the change. يخلق ما يشاء. He creates whoever he wants. يهب يهب. Please give me attention to the word يهب لمن يشاء إناثا. He gives whoever one females, daughters. ويهب لمن يشاء الذكور. First one إناث without ألف لام. Give attention. And الذكور with ألف لام. أو the ayah after that. أو يزوجهم ذكرانا وإناثا. He gives them married, male and female. Now he mentioned male first and female. In the beginning, he mentioned female first and male. ويجعل من يشاء عقيما. And he creates somebody cannot have kids. Cannot have kids at all. And in the end, إنه عليم قدير. Ayah number 49 and 15 سورة الشورى. Ayah number 59 and 50 in Surah what? Ash-Shura. If you have the book, open the book or open the Quran in Ayah number 49 and Ayah 50. Again, Allah Azza wa Jal speaking about the heaven and the earth. The heaven and the earth. We speak of Aqeedah. Please give me your attention to the Aqeedah here. Heaven and the earth. And then speaking about male and female born. See the what is the relationship? What is, please, anybody can tell me what is the relationship between that? Huh? What that brings? What is the relationship? Allah speaking about heaven and earth. بين ملك السماوات والأرض. I'm creating human being. Anybody? There is a relationship. Master and slaves. He create two, praying the heaven and the earth harder. Yes. Alban. Yes. Very good. That is the answer. That is the answer here. Alban. Say heaven, the earth. A lot harder to create what? Human being. Heaven, this heaven, the earth, the miracle of the heavens and the earth. Look at this earth. The earth we studied. How so complicated. And what we know about the earth. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. What Allah gave you from the knowledge, from the ilm is very few. Very few, a drop. You know the story of Al-Khadr, and Musa alayhi salam with the, in the ship, what happened? A bird take a drop of water from the ocean, from the sea. A bird, one drop. And then Al-Khadr told Musa alayhi salam, my knowledge and your knowledge compared to the knowledge of Allah, just like that bird taken from the ocean. See, the ocean will decrease, the ocean or the sea or the river decreased. No. It's not decreased. Okay. Now, when we speak about the heaven and the earth, we have to speak that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-mudabbir, al-rabb, al-mudabbir, the one He fashioned this universe and He know exactly the road or the way of the sun and the way of the Mars and the way of the Mercury and the way of the Uranus and you name it. He know exactly our galaxy, how it works, and the other galaxy how it works, and the other galaxy how it works, and so on. All the galaxies. All right? 10 minutes, inshallah. إن شاء الله. I finish إن شاء الله. All right. So Allah, when we speak about the heaven and the earth, we speak about Al-Mudabbir, Al-Rabb, the one, his greatness, he fashioned the heaven and the earth and how it works. يخلق ما يشاء. Now, يخلق ما يشاء. الخلق, الخلق, the creation in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. When we said we create the door, we create the, this curtain, we create this bed from things Allah has created already. Allah has created already. So it means Allah is the creator for everything. يخلق ما يشاء. ما يشاء here, this means whatever he wants, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can he create. And we spoke about this before, that Allah is the best of the creation, أحسن الخالقين. And then he said, يَهَبُ يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ يَهَبْ هِبَة. What's هِبَة in Arabic language? Huh? Gift, yes. هِبَة is what? Gift. When I give you gift, huh? When I give you gift, that means I'm not waiting to give me the gift back. I cannot take the gift from you. I give it to you, that's it, it's yours. Gift. This means me is a gift to my father and my mother. You is a gift for your father and your mother. Yahab, Hiba. But this gift from whom? From Allah. It's so beautiful. This means Allah give you this gift free. A gift, always you don't pay for the gift. Do you pay for the gift? No, you don't pay for the gift. Allah Azza wa Jalla give يهب لمن يشاء إناثا ويهب لمن يشاء الذكور. إناثا that نكرة unknown and الذكور is known. الذكور إناثا does mean females. إناثا females and الذكور males, the males. Now some people that says why would the إناث females before males, females before males, and in that time, please give me your attention, before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how is the woman she used to be treated? Humiliated, she have no rights. The woman in that time, so humiliated, she have no rights. When she get divorced, she get out of the house. No kids, no money, no alimony, no nothing. But when the Islam came, Surah called it Al-Nisa, Surah called it Al-Talaq, Surah called it Al-Mujadala, Surah called it Maryam, honor the woman. The Islam, honor, that is our aqeedah. That the woman is not like what they think or used to think. No, استغفر الله العظيم. The woman, it is a part. Well, Allah عز وجل described إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات وسورة الأحزاب. Man and woman, man and woman, صائمين صائمات, متصدقين متصدقات, الذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. All this من and woman, من and woman, worshiping Allah سبحانه وتعالى. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said من and woman شقائق, شقائق النساء شقائق الرجال والشقائق. They're exactly the same. In ibadah, in the matter of ibadah, men and women are the same. Some, but before the Islam, women, she have no value. No value. But our aqeedah, aqeedah Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the woman, there is a value for the woman. The woman is my mother. The woman is my sister. The woman is my aunt. The woman is my niece. The woman is Khadija and Aisha, that is the woman. Respect and honor for the woman. That when Allah Azza wa Jal put the woman in Athan. And there is another reason, another hikmah. That was the hikmah the ulama said. But definitely, there is more wisdom behind that, my dear brothers and sisters. A lot more wisdom, more than that. Okay, we're going to have 5 minutes. And 5 minutes, inshallah, 15 minutes of question and answer, if you have, or 5 minutes of question and answer. But let me just put this, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, when he said, al-dhukur, you know, in the time before the Islam, when somebody, Allah even mentioned that in the Quran, وإذا بشر أحدهم بالأنثى ظل وجهه مسودا وهو كظيم يتوارى من الغيظ من سوء ما بشر به. لا إله إلا الله. Say when somebody have the news they have a daughter, somebody in heaven news you have a daughter, what is he? He run away from the people. He run away من سوء ما بشر به. So they have the very bad news, والعياذ بالله, that he have a daughter. من سوء ما بشر he was just like he put his face like this, hiding his face in the sand, hiding his face in the sand because of the woman. Subhanallah Rabbi. But you know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he loved Fatima the way no one, he made an example, he set up an example in Fatima رضي الله عنها. When he sees Fatima coming, he stand up and he makes Fatima sit in his place, hugging Fatima and sit in his place, his daughter, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is Fatima. When he travel anywhere, go to Fatima and then go to his house. He go Fatima and visit his daughter, the way he loved his daughter Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha.